ChatGPT can do a lot of things, but can it play a social deduction game? To answer this question, we had ChatGPT play our game Trust No Bunny. We are not AI experts, but we are experts on games about treacherous rabbits stabbing each other in the back, and we want to see what an AI will do with this.
Fair. Fair deal.
AIs are very good at playing games with discrete game states, symmetric information, and games that require a lot of calculation. Chess and Go are good examples here. But what about games that contain asymmetric information, or games that you have to lie in? Social deduction games are a particularly big challenge for AI, as playing successfully means not only being able to optimize actions given a game state, but also manipulating others, selectively lying, and assessing whether others are doing the same. Rather than having an AI play Trust No Bunny over and over again to learn the game, we instead use ChatGPT-4 since it not only is a great AI for communicating, but it also has great deductive reasoning skills. We connected ChatGPT to our social deduction game, Trust No Bunny. We gave it the same controls that a player would have, as well as access to the player chat, and we took it for a spin. Just so you can understand the results, I'll walk you through how Trust No Bunny works. The game can get fairly complicated, so for simplicity's sake, I'll just explain the core mechanics using a 5-player game as an example. In Trust No Bunny, a bunny village is under attack by ravenous wolves each night. The bunnies are trying to defend the village, except not all the bunnies are actually bunnies. Some are werebunnies, and are secretly trying to aid the wolves in destroying the village. The townsfolk, the 3 good players, win the game if the village survives 5 rounds. The 2 werebunnies win if the village defenses are destroyed during that time. Players take turns defending the town in groups of 2 or 3. These players are decided through a nomination and voting process. A successfully voted on team then goes to the guardhouse where they play cards from a set of cards in their hand. The combined values of the players' cards must be equal to or greater than the number of wolves attacking. Otherwise, the village defenses take damage. The defenders coordinate their actions, but ultimately don't see how many points each other is playing. The rub is that werebunnies can play cards as attack cards, effectively adding to the number of wolves attacking. At the end of the round, all the players see the results. Does the village take damage or not? Over the course of the game, if the defenses take 25 or more damage, the werebunnies win. Now that you understand the basics of how Trust No Bunny works, let's dive into how well ChatGPT plays. Here's game number 1. And here's me. I'm a townsfolk, which means I'm trying to ensure the town's survival, playing against 4 other ChatGPT-controlled bots. Here, 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 and here. As the game starts, Felix and I are nominated and approved to defend the town for the night. Felix and I go to the guardhouse on the first night. We coordinate with each other to spend enough cards to defend against the wolves. Felix says they'll play their entire hand to defend for the night, which seems like dubious resource management. Nevertheless, we defend successfully. Felix and I are now buds. On the next night, Jin suggests Archie. No one has any more information to suggest anyone over anyone else, so why not take Archie? Given that I know there are 2 werebunnies in this game, I'm obviously somewhat suspicious, as I'm pretty sure Felix is good here. That leaves Ginge, Archie, and Twigs as possible suspects here. Spoiler, the werebunnies are Ginge and Archie. But hey, I'll go along with it, believing they're noble townsfolk until given a reason to believe otherwise. Lo and behold, the defenses take damage, a total of 10 damage. Not good. I now firmly believe that Archie must be a werebunny. When we get back to town, I tell everyone what I think. Archie vehemently denies this, though he doesn't really give a compelling explanation as to why the town defenses experienced the damage they did. Felix becomes suspicious of Archie as well. Despite this, he still makes the move to nominate Archie for the next set of guards. I'm now at the guardhouse with Ginge and Archie. Archie claims that he'll play a 2, and Jin says that she'll play a 4. The town defenses get completely demolished, thanks to Felix's half-baked decision to nominate Archie for the team. I did find it impressive, though, that Ginge suggested that Archie go on the second night, when we needed a 3rd guard. Remember, werebunnies know who each other are. I make some adjustments to the GPT prompts and launch some more games. Again and again, the bots were able to not only handle the game actions, playing cards, nominating teams, etc., but were also able to make actions that involved trying to convince other players to take actions, for example, or even possibly thinking ahead to what game state would be like in a turn or two. And this is all tech that's being updated day to day. We're really excited to see what our ChatGPT AI bots are going to be able to do in the coming weeks and months. As the tech gets updated, we'll be tweaking and improving our bots as well. Trust No Bunny is available on Steam right now. We would love for you to give it a try. Remember, this is a game designed to be played with other humans, but we will be including a ChatGPT bot. As the bot gets better, pretty soon we might not have any need for humans at all.